35 years ago, 100% of NBA players were American or had American citizenship. In 2021, NBA rosters featured 107 international players from 41 countries, or about a quarter of the entire league. Most of those players come from Europe, and in this video, we'll talk about the 10 best European players to ever play in the NBA. Number 10. Peja Stojakovic. Peja Stojakovic was one of the best shooters in NBA history. Stojakovic is a 40% shooter for three in his career, one of the best marks ever before the three-point revolution. But Peja was even better from the charity stripe, and his 89.5 free throw percentage is still the fourth best on the all-time leaderboard. The Serbian marksman peaked during his time with the Sacramento Kings, when the Kings were led by Chris Webber and were among the best teams in the league. With 24.2 points per game, Stojakovic was the second-best scorer in the league in 2004, behind Tracy McGrady, and he made three All-Star teams when it was extremely hard to become an All-Star in the West. Stojakovic went out on top, retiring after he helped the Mavericks to win the title in 2011. Number 9. Arvydas Sabonis. Arvydas Sabonis is a basketball giant, both literally and metaphorically. Standing at 7'3" and nearly 300 pounds, there hasn't been a basketball player at that size with that much skill, ever. Even though he was an enormous brute, Sabonis had an extremely high basketball IQ and feel for the game. He could see the floor better than most point guards and shoot better than most wings. Sabonis started playing in the early 80s, and back then, he was an amazing athlete, incredibly coordinated and athletic for his size. He was a bulldozer and a ballet dancer in one, and he was easily the most dominant big man in Europe, winning a plethora of club, international, and individual trophies. The only thing that could slow Sabonis down were numerous injuries, and he suffered through torn Achilles on both legs, alongside numerous other knee and ankle injuries. He came to the NBA at the age of 31, and before he started playing for the Trailblazers as the oldest rookie in NBA history, Portland's doctors famously said that he could have gotten a disabled parking permit based on the x-rays of his feet and knees. However, even though his mobility was extremely hampered at that point, Sabonis became the focal point of the Blazers' offense and delighted the crowds with his skill set, helping the Blazers to reach the Western Finals twice. Number 8. Toni Kukoč. Kukoč was a prototype of a tall player who can do anything. At 6'10", he could dribble, pass, and shoot as well as any guard, and he could play all five positions on the court, which would be even more valuable in today's NBA predicated on shooting. By his 24th birthday, Kukoč had won everything in Europe: 3 EuroLeague titles, 5 national championships, and 3 national cups, which were accompanied by numerous individual awards. He picked up the gold medal in the MVP trophy at the 1990 World Cup, defeating Team USA in the semifinal, after which the Americans decided that they needed to start sending pro players to international competitions, resulting in the formation of the Dream Team 2 years later. Against the Dream Team in the 92 Olympics, Kukoč wasn't as successful, but he still helped Croatia to reach the finals and win the silver medal. Toni then joined the Chicago Bulls in 1993, where he proved to be an invaluable part of the Bulls' second three-peat. Kukoč won the Sixth Man of the Year award in 1996, and even though his numbers are not as great as some of the current European stars, that's largely because he played with MJ and Pippen, who took the vast majority of the shots. If he played on a lottery team, he could have easily averaged over 20 every season. But Toni wasn't about the numbers. He preferred winning trophies. He's one of the most decorated European players ever, and he will finally get into the Hall of Fame in the class of 2021. Number 7. Drazen Petrovic. Before he came to the NBA, Petrovic was the European version of Michael Jordan, a 6'6" shooting guard who was extremely competitive, a maniacal worker, and the deadliest scorer. Petrovic won scoring titles in every league he played in, along with many national cups and championships, 2 EuroLeague trophies, and 7 international medals. Kids watching the NBA wanted to be like Mike, and the kids across the ocean who were watching the EuroLeague wanted to be like Drazen. With nothing else to prove in Europe, Petrovic was one of the first Euros to come to the NBA in 1989, and he didn't get a warm welcome as he expected. He sat on the bench for 2 years in Portland behind all-star guards Clyde Drexler and Terry Porter, until he was finally fed up and granted a move to the New Jersey Nets. With the Nets, Petrovic blossomed, averaging 20 points in three seasons, shooting a phenomenal 51% from the field and 44% from three. He's currently at fifth place in all-time three-point accuracy, and before Steph Curry came along, some people considered him to be the greatest shooter ever. Unfortunately, Petrovic died in a car accident in 1993 at the age of 28 in the prime of his career. Number 6. Luka Doncic. Luka Doncic is a basketball phenom who started his pro career at Real Madrid at the age of 16. By the age of 19, Doncic had already become the best player in Europe, winning the EuroLeague trophy and becoming the youngest player ever to win the EuroLeague MVP, along with the Spanish League MVP and the European gold with Slovenia. Before he was able to legally buy beer in America, Luka had won every possible trophy in Europe, onto which he added the NBA Rookie of the Year award, becoming the first rookie since Oscar Robertson with at least 20 points, 7 rebounds, and 5 assists per game. The young Slovenian became the player who reached 2,000 points in the NBA in fewest games, not only the first from Europeans, but in the history of the league. Luka is not just the most important piece in the Mavs' offensive system. Doncic himself is the system, and everything runs through him. It's incredible that a player so young can be this dominant, especially since he's not physically overwhelming like LeBron, Shaq, or MJ. Luka is only 22 at the moment, and he already made 2 All-NBA first teams in just 3 NBA seasons. When it's all said and done, he'll probably climb this list and retire as the best European player ever. Number 5. Nikola Jokic. There are many similarities between Nikola Jokic and Dirk Nowitzki. Both are 7-footers. Both are unathletic and relatively slow compared to the rest of the NBA. They can shoot it from anywhere, and both guys have deadly one-legged fadeaways. They also share the accomplishment of the most valuable player in the NBA. While Jokic will probably never be the prolific go-to scorer that Dirk was, that's not because he can't score. It's because he is the best passing big man in the history of the game. We're not just talking European players here either. Jokic really is the best passing center ever, which is proven both by numbers and with the eye test. Jokic is an above-average offensive player in terms of scoring, but when we're talking about passing, the way he sees the court, the way he handles the ball, his small touches, his volleyball passes, behind the back or passes into an empty space, that's pure genius. Since he became a starter for the Nuggets, the Joker is averaging over 7 assists per game, and as far as centers go, only Wilt had more assists than Jokic did this last season, but Wilt averaged 12 minutes per game more than the Big Serb. Number 4. Tony Parker. When he first came to San Antonio as a 19-year-old kid, every jersey was oversized for his skinny frame, and Tim Duncan complained that they would never win another title with a European point guard. It's been 20 years since he first came to the Spurs, and Tony Parker has retired from basketball as the best European point guard ever, proving his dear friend Timmy very, very wrong. Parker was one of the fastest players in the NBA for years, slaloming through opposing defenses, getting to the rim with ease, or finishing with his trademark teardrop floater, one of the best floaters we've ever seen. He was a key member of the Spurs dynasty alongside Duncan and Ginobili, winning 4 NBA titles, including the Finals MVP trophy in 2007, and 6 All-Star appearances. Alongside his NBA success, Parker also won 4 medals at the European Championships with the national team, most notably the 2013 Eurobasket, where he led France to the gold and was named the tournament MVP. Number 3. Pau Gasol. Pau Gasol has never gained a divine status in the NBA like Dirk had in Dallas, and had never played at the MVP level of Luka and Giannis today. That's primarily because he didn't score as much as they did. Pau had only 2 seasons with 20-plus points as a member of the Grizzlies. Gasol will mostly be remembered for his time with the Lakers, where he developed incredible chemistry with Kobe, and where he was the perfect sidekick to Bryant on their way to 2 NBA titles. Pau was a great all-around player in the NBA, the first foreigner to win Rookie of the Year, and a 6-time All-Star, but never a superstar. However, what puts Gasol in a different stratosphere is his superstar status in the international tournaments. Pau was, without a doubt, the most dominant European player of this century, winning 7 medals at the European Championships, including 3 golds, 1 gold medal in the World Cup, and 3 Olympic medals. Number 2. Giannis Antetokounmpo. Giannis came into the NBA as an extremely unknown, extremely raw, and extremely skinny prospect from Greece. Very few people even knew about this kid. Almost nobody thought that he would be good, and absolutely nobody knew how to pronounce his last name. Fast forward 8 years, and he became so good that everybody knows how to pronounce his name. Okay, almost everybody. Giannis became so good that he won 2 consecutive MVP awards, joining Kareem Abdul-Jabbar and LeBron James as the only players in NBA history to win 2 MVPs before turning 26. Along with the MVP, he was also named the NBA Defensive Player of the Year in 2020, becoming only the 3rd player after Michael Jordan and Hakeem Olajuwon to win both awards in the same season. Antetokounmpo might not be your typical European. Well, because he isn't. His parents are Nigerian, and he doesn't dominate the game because he's a good shooter and crafty dribbler. Giannis is the most physically dominant player ever coming from Europe, and that's why everybody calls him the Greek Freak. And before we proceed to the number one spot on the list, we have to mention some guys who barely missed the cut, like Vlade Divac, Detlef Schrempf, Marc Gasol, Goran Dragic, and Rudy Gobert. Number 1. Dirk Nowitzki. He's one of 7 players who have scored over 30,000 points in the NBA, making him also the best European scorer ever. Dirk was the first European player to win the MVP award in the NBA, a 14-time All-Star, 12 times in all NBA teams, a member of the 50-40-90 club, and the tallest person ever to win a 3-point shooting contest. And just when it seemed that he'd be another great player that never won a championship, Dirk surprised the world at the back end of his prime in 2011. He played the best basketball of his career and won the first championship in Mavericks history, averaging 28 points during his magical playoff run, shooting 46% from 3, 94% from the free throw line, and certifying his one-legged fadeaway as one of the most unstoppable moves in NBA history. His NBA resume is thicker than any other European player, and that's why he belongs at the top of this list.